Michigan researchers are developing a method for filtering contaminated fracking water. Hydraulic fracturing, or fracking, is the extraction of oil or gas from a rock formation that is not permeable. In order to fracture the rock formation, fracking companies inject a water-based solution at pressures up to 9,000 psi. This solution is used to free up oil or gas within the rock formation. While the large volume of flowback water generated in the hydraulic fracturing process can be recycled in principle and reused, it is cost prohibitive to treat all of it conventionally, and thus large volumes are instead disposed in deep injection wells. These injection wells have been linked to earthquakes in their immediate area. Michigan researchers are developing a new method for filtering the unsafe fracking water by introducing plasma into it. This new filtering method could potentially allow the fracking water to be more cost-effectively recycled and reused.
Well, what is a plasma? Plasma is this collection of electrons and ions. It's charge. You expose this charged gas, this plasma, to water, that charge can essentially deposit itself on particles. Those clump together to form larger particles. They settle to the bottom, and you can now filter those out.
The advantage of plasma is that you don't require external chemical storage or transport for these chemicals, such as hydrogen peroxide or ozone, which are traditionally injected into water from an external source in order to achieve that chemical reactivity. The plasma chemical reactivity comes directly from the energetic electron interactions with the water molecules that are already present in the fracking water.
When you're talking about these operations that you're dealing with, millions of gallons of water. In the laboratory, we're dealing with gallons of water. So we have to scale that up. And not only do we like to scale it up to accommodate thousands to millions of gallons of water, but we also would like to make sure that the power requirements to do that are reasonable. So in collaboration with NASA, we have developed a methodology to scale up these plasma jets to accommodate large amounts of water. We developed a notional 1 million gallon per day facility.
If this research is successful, then we can potentially reuse that water for more fracking, such that those oil and gas companies don't have to withdraw as much water. The other option is that once this water has been treated to the point where it can be introduced to a wastewater plant, that water can ultimately end up back in the freshwater reserves for that local population.